Let's talk about automation. Maybe you're in the early stages of your automation journey. You know exactly how to use conventional controllers and you're comfortable with them. But you've also heard about the advantages of being able to see your site conditions from one central place without having to drive your route. Sounds interesting, but you may not know where to start. Or maybe you've incorporated automation at your facility. You know how remote communication works, but you wonder if the initial cost of programming and parts is really worth it. In this video, I'm going to introduce you to a solution that addresses both of these concerns. Hi, I'm Kyle with Kimray, where we help energy producers solve their biggest control challenges. Today, I'm excited to tell you about a new solution, the electric valve controller. The electric valve controller is a compact, easy-to-use solution for remote monitoring and control of your production process. The controller is a package of five components: the electric pilot, IDP positioner, transducer, supply gas regulator, drip pot, and control valve. Let's walk through what each of these parts does. The transducer measures process pressure and gives a raw 4 to 20 milliamp signal to the pilot. The electric pilot takes that signal and converts it to a proportional 4 to 20 milliamp signal and sends that to the IDP positioner. The IDP positioner receives this electrical input as well as the supply gas input. The supply gas input comes through the drip pot, which removes excess condensate, and the supply gas regulator, which keeps the pressure to a manageable level to allow adequate feed to the input of the IDP. The IDP positioner converts that electric input signal to a corresponding 6 to 30 psi output signal and sends that level of supply gas to the high pressure control valve. Producers who use the electric valve controller have reported four key advantages. First, it's easy to use. The pilot features a simple three-button interface that makes programming and changing set points fast and easy for any operator. Second, it's cost-effective. At this point, you may not need a complex multi-channel system for your site. With the electric valve controller, you can automate one controller per valve without the use of an RTU or PLC. The components of the controller can also be replaced individually. So if one piece is having an issue, the replacement cost is much less than replacing an entire unit. Third, it has a low power draw. The EVC requires low voltage power supply, and operators have successfully and consistently run the EVC on solar power, even in commonly overcast regions of the US. A fourth advantage is the pilot's standard override feature. In an upset condition, the pilot will receive a signal from another controller as a discrete input. The discrete input overrides the analog output to the IDP. This forces the valve to its fail position and provides an output signal to an alarm or other device. Examples of a discrete override include high or low pressure, temperature, flow, or liquid level. The electric valve controller can be used to provide back pressure on a separator, suction control on a compressor, pressure differential on a meter run, high-low gap control on the inlet of a gas processing unit, and it can handle higher pressure applications than most pilot-operated pneumatic packages. We have authorized technicians in every basin ready to help you automate your processes. Want to see how easy it is to set up your electric pilot? Watch this next video.